Hi, this is Dave from Pandemic Hall Production, and today we're going to paint these walls. We got all the foam carving done, everything's finished. I even put my pandemic symbol in the other day. I was feeling bored and I wanted to do something a little different, and the wall needed a little something extra, so I have my biohazard symbol that I have for my logo, and I thought it would be a perfect place to put it. But we're going to paint everything else today. I'm going to show you all my techniques and how I do it. I'm not going to bore you with the stupid shit. I'm not going to bore you with how to prime your walls properly and how to do paint, because everybody knows how to paint a wall. I'm going to show you the good stuff and how to make the wall look old. So I hope you enjoy it. First, we're going to start with the cracks and the grout lines. We're going to paint them black. You can use a paintbrush if you would like. I'm going to use an airbrush. It's a lot faster and a lot easier. But a small paintbrush would work just fine. You have to use a latex paint. Don't use spray paint, because spray paint's just going to make the foam eat away more. And all our texture is done, so we don't want to do any more texture, we just want to paint. So latex, black latex paint is what I'm using right now. So we're just going to go along with the airbrush and just paint my lines. Now, they don't have to be neat and perfect. It's not. You can go anywhere you want. Just try to get the black paint in the crack. We're going to paint over the outside later. That's why we're doing the cracks first. Cracks and the grout are all finished now. Two coats of black paint. It took me about 15 minutes to do the whole wall, which isn't bad. I'm gonna let this dry for 24 hours. I'll come back tomorrow and I'll do some more work. Now we can do the base colors. Two base colors. So I got a dark gray, I think it's called like a granite or whatever else it's called, for the block, and I have a kind of a nasty, disgusting like color. I don't even know what it is. It's just kind of messed up color. Nobody would want to paint their house this color, but it'd be perfect for a dungeon wall. Now, this is just a base coat, so it's not the finished color. It's not the finished technique. It's just that. So I'll go through that quick. The block wall painted. I'm gonna let that dry, and as that's drying, I'm going to paint the smooth section. But before we do that, I'm gonna add this product to my paint. It's a non-skid floor finish additive. You add it to a gallon of paint, and when you paint your floor, it adds a non-skid finish. But what I'm using it for is the textured finish that it gives. You could use sand. You could use a whole bunch of other things to add a texture, but this is really good because it's subtle. It doesn't scratch if you brush against it, and it's really easy to mix with paint. That's exactly what it's for. It's for paint. So you add this bag to a gallon of paint, and you apply it to a wall just like you would be painting a wall. Now the base coat is all finished, it's all dry, let it dry overnight. Now we're going to do the fun stuff. The fun stuff is going to be messy, I'm going to use a stain. It's just regular old polyurethane stain. It's called American Chestnut. It's a really dark reddish, brownish type stain. They have so many different color stains. You can use whatever you want. They even have a black stain that works really nice for this. But we're going to go over with a stain color, and it's going to give it that really nasty, disgusting look that we were going for in our pandemic workshop here. Alright, so I dumped the stain in a bucket, a nice big bucket, and I got a nice wad of cheesecloth. Everybody knows what cheesecloth is. You want to soak it really good and wring it out. You want it to be fairly dry. You don't want to have a ton of a stain on it. You just want it pretty dry. And what you're going to do, after it drips all over your hands and everything, you're going to go over the wall and just blot it on and rub it around. Like so. And then you're going to take a dry piece of cheesecloth and wipe it off in a way. And what you get is nice and mucky looking wall. They don't have to be even with it. You're not supposed to be even with it. But do the whole wall just like that. I gotta admit, this is probably the messiest thing you're ever gonna do. The shit gets everywhere. It's all over the floor, it's all over my hands, my arms. Make sure you wear rubber gloves. It is a mess, but it is so worth it. I mean, the look is just, it's something you can't get from paint. This video isn't gonna give it any justice. I mean, you're really not gonna get this look with paint. Stain is really a great way to go. You definitely want to change out your clean rag all the time. I ran out of cheesecloth, so now I'm using paper towels. All works the same. Now for the block. We're going to use, I call it the dry brush technique. Everybody that does faux finishes know how to use the dry brush. Using just regular white paint. You put a little bit on the brush and you dry it off. I have a piece of foam here. Put a little white paint and then you do that until it's all almost completely off the brush. Then come over to the block and you're just going to lightly go over it. We're also going to use the exact same dry brush technique for my symbol here, just to give it a little accent. I'm also going to go over it with a little red because that's what my symbol looks like. That's it. All done. Finally finished. The pandemic main wall is finished for today. All the paint's dry, and it looks really good. Tell me what you think. Tell me any ideas that you might have that might have been better for me, because I'm always trying to learn different ways to do things. I'm always trying to find a better technique, something a little faster. This is a pretty fast way, though, so try it out for yourself. Thanks. My name's Dave from Pandemic Home Production, and thank you for watching.